One of the many new lock screen options is called Photo Shuffle, and here the iPhone will automatically curate a selection of pictures that will look great on your home screen. Here's a quick guide to setting it up and personalizing it. So first of all, we're going to pull down from the top of our screen to bring up our lock screen, and then I'm going to tap and hold and add a new lock screen. From here at the top, I'm going to choose the Photo Shuffle option, and straight away you're going to have a choice to make. The Photo Shuffle works with images in different categories: people, nature, pets, and cities. And you can toggle on or off any or all of these options. It may be you want nature and pets, or perhaps people and cities, or maybe just one of them. For my lock screen, I'm going to go for cities. Now, as I'm changing these toggles, you'll notice at the top there that preview images are being changed in real time as well. At the bottom of the screen, you can select images manually, but because this feature is very clever, I think the ones it's chosen are perfect for me. We're then going to choose how often the picture changes. It could be every hour, every day, or every time you tap the lock screen. I'll go for that option so you can see how quickly it will change. Then, when we continue, we get our preview of the lock screen. Now, we can see straight away we've got a nice big picture of a building in the background, which I think is quite cool. It's got a nice shape to it, it's nice and geometric, it appeals to me. But I don't like the colours at all. This is the colour of the original photograph. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to swipe sideways across my screen and apply some different filters to it. First of all, we've got black and white, then we've got duotone and colour overlay. Now, I like that duotone look with two colours. Let's go back to that. The really cool thing about duotone is you can actually choose what colour it uses to influence that picture. So if we press the three dots in the bottom corner, we can then set the style colour. Also, at this moment, if you wanted to take a picture out of rotation, so perhaps you don't want this picture as part of that rotation at all, you can ask to feature this one less. From here, I can then choose from the colour palette to decide what colour would look good against this picture. Now, I quite like this green tint, I think. Next up, I'm going to customise the time at the top by tapping on it and changing the font. We can also change the colour here as well. I'm going to go for a green colour to match the duotone, but I'm going to make it nice and bright so it really pops out against the background photograph. Then I'll drag a couple of widgets on, one for the home app and one for the weather. And now I'm pretty happy with how this lock screen is coming together. So let's see how it works with different images. I'm going to press done, and then I'm going to select this as my current lock screen. I'll add the wallpaper pair as well, so I've got that nice greeny blue on my home screen. And then when I just tap the wallpaper, it will change to the next picture in the rotation. As it changes, you can see the duotone effect works amazingly across all these different photographs, and they've all been chosen by the onboard processor on my iPhone to look great as lock screens. I am really pleased with how this looks, and I'll be using this as my lock screen for a long time to come.